Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn how to create generic response for our REST API in our Spring Boot project. And we'll also learn what is response and what is response entity. And after that we will create our generic response object, and we'll also learn the benefit of using generic response in our Spring Boot project. So okay, let's start. So first we will start from what is response. In our web project, the response refers to the data sent back to the client by the server after the client makes a request from the web. So when a client makes a request from a web browser, or we can say any postman or mobile application, so request a resource from the server, the server processes the request and provides a response back to client. So this is known as response. So what is response entity? So in our Spring Boot project, the response entity is a class that represents the entire HTTP response and is derived from the HTTP entity class. So what we mean by the entire HTTP response, that is status code, header and the body, that we can change this feature of the response from our controller methods. Let's go to the code and we'll use response entity while we will return response. So here I have created one Spring Boot project, and in this project I have created multiple REST endpoint. So first is get mapping, and with this API we will just return string value. And second, I have created get all employees, so it will return list of employee. Like this I have created update and delete API also. So okay, first we will do the changes for this get API, get employee by name. So first I will start this project and will test our REST API. So here I have also created one entity class. So inside this entity class I have declared all the properties like employee ID, employee name, employee age, salary and address. So these five properties I have declared inside our entity class. So if I will go to my DB, so here we can see this is the entity class, employee ID, employee name, age, salary, address. So here we can see 7 or 8 records are available in this class. And here I have created one model class, that is employee class, and same properties I have defined here in the model class. And I am also using lobox. So here I have declared annotation @data or @all or constructor. These are lobox annotations. So no need to write any setter getter method for these properties. And one I have created repository class. So inside repository I have just declared repository class and created one method find by name. And here I have created employee service implementation class. So here I have provided the implementation for all the methods after interacting with DBs. So okay, let's run this API and we'll test one by one. So first I will start my Spring Boot project. So first we will just check the response of one API, that is get employee by name. So after that we will do some modification and we'll try to create generic response for all API. So that will be easy to handle at our client side. So here we can see our application has started. And in our pom.xml, I have also added Swagger annotation, Swagger Maven dependency. So we can see our API here. So here we can see our all APIs that we have defined inside our controller. These are the 5 APIs, 6 APIs that we have created. So I will just call get API, get employee name by its ID. So here I will just pass the employee ID 14 and we'll try to execute. So here we will get the response. So here I am getting status code is 200, and inside response body I am just getting response as Harish, and inside response header I am getting 5 values, that is connection keep alive, content length, content type, date keep alive. But here I am getting 5 properties. But if I want to add some more properties in response header, then we need to use response entity. So let me go back to our controller class and we'll use response entity for our response. So here I will just add response entity and return type will be string, and here we need to use return new response entity. Dot status http status, so okay for, and we no need to use new keyword here. So if I want to return headers, so here I will just use headers tag, and here I will just add custom header. So as we checked, we will getting 5 headers value in our response headers. So here we have already checked, we are just getting 1 2 3 4 5. So now I will add one more property, that is custom header, and its value will be new header. And another thing, if you want to add body, so here I will just pass any message or response that we are getting from here, so we can add, or we can just return success also. So here I will just add the response. So let me recall this API again. So I will just execute. So need to check the response again. But before that, we need to restart our application. So let me stop and start it again. So here I have just added response entity to handle our API response, and now I will go back and recall this API. So let me execute this endpoint again, get employee name. So here we can see response body as Harish and status code is 200, and here we can see our custom header, that is new header, we have added. So like this, we can change the response with the help of response entity, and we can also update or change the status code of API. Let's create our generic response object, and we'll also learn the benefit of creating generic response object for our REST APIs. And we can say that generic response is a term used to express a general response class. So this type of class provides us with a generalized structure to cover the different types of data that the API can return. So thus we can return various responses to the client, such as success information, error message, data and other relevant information through the same format for all API. So the generic response class will contain properties, these are common to every response returned from the API. So this structure will enable to standardize the field such as error code, messages and return data, and to design a consistent structure for responses from different endpoints. So let me create one generic response class in our project and we'll use for our API. So let me go to our model class, and here I will create one new class, new Java class. So I will give the name generic response. So this is a name I have given to my class. So let me define properties inside this generic response class. So this is our generic class. So here I will just define private boolean status, and another property we can define private string message, and like we can define private data. So data, it will handle all types of data type. So here I will use numbok annotation, that is @data, so no need to write any setter getter. And @builder, so we can use builder method while creating the object of our generic response class. And we can also use @all our constructor. So these three annotations I have defined just at our class level, and this is our generic response class. So by using this structure, we will design our responses according to single format, and we will return our responses to client only in the same format. Okay, let's rewrite our controller method, and instead of status we can also use success. So here we can use success as a property name also. So let me go to my controller class, employee controller, and here we can change the response type. So here I will just use, so we can just remove response entity first. So here I will define generic response, and return type is string. So here I will just return generic response string dot builder. So here I can define generic response builder. So here we just need to define the properties that we have declared inside our generic response class, that is success. So we can just define success. We have defined two dots, so it was showing some issue. So success, in success we can write true or false, and we can also type the message, that is get name successfully. So we can define any message according to our requirement, and here we can just define data. So we have defined generic response, so here I will just get the name from the API from our repository. So let me stop our application and start it again. So here I am just using generic response model class that we have created here, and these are the three properties, success, message and data, that I have used. So I have started my application and check the response back again. So this time I am not using response entity. So after that we will also see how to use the response entity and generic response together for same API. So here our application has started at port number 8080. So let me go back to browser and recall this API, that is get employee by name with the help of ID. So here we can see the response, that is response body with status code 200, and here we can see the success is true, and message is get name successfully, and data is Harish that we are getting. So before that we are just getting the name as Harish, but not getting this format. So this is the common structure that we can use. So here we will try to use. So let me call another API, That is get all employees. So here we are just getting the single string value, but if you want to get all object, so let me go back and here I will call get all employees and we'll use the generic response object here. Generic response. And here we need to use same structure. So let me go above and copy paste the same code here. So here I will just copy it and go down, scroll down. So I will paste it here. And here I will cut this part. So this service class will return list of all employees. So here I will just change in the data. I will pass set the list of employees. And here we also need to change list of employee. And here we also need to add list of employee. So let me stop this application and start it again. But I have not changed the message from here. So we will get the same message, get name successfully. But in the response, we will get list of employees. So our application has started. So let me go back to browser. So here I will call first get employee by name API. So here we can see the response structure, success, message and data. So now let me call the get employee list of employee API. So this API will return list of employee. So let me call this API and we'll check the response structure here. So here we can see we are getting the response body, that is success, true, message is get name successfully, and in our data is generic, so we can set any type of data. So this is the list of employees that we have set, and we are getting list of all employees in the response model. So like this we can use our generic response model structure for our all APIs. So it will be easy to handle at our client side while consuming our REST API in front end. So this is the code snippet and this is the basic idea. So now let's change the generic response class a little to improve the code quality and do some more. So let me go back to our generic response class. So here we have defined only three properties. So now here I will just define all the methods. So we no need to write methods inside our controller class. So here I will just define all the methods and we'll call directly. So first I will create one method to return empty response, generic response t, and method name we can define empty. So here we can just return property success. But here it's showing some error. So here it's showing error because we have declared non-static field inside our static block. So we can make this field as static. So let's add static. Static. So here I will just copy the method from here that we have created here. So let me copy all and go back to our generic response class, and here I will just paste it here. And success, I have added true, or we can add false and we can leave it as empty. And data, we can also leave it as blank or null. And here we can just pass t like this. We can add more methods for error message or success response. So let me add one more function, that is for success. It was for empty. So for success we can add like this, and here we can add true, and inside data we will pass here t data that we will get from our API, and we will set the same response here, and inside message we can just pass success. And paste it here, and here we can pass, we have passed these three properties, success, true, message, success, and data. We have set the response that we will get from our DB. Like this we can add one more method for failure. So let me create one more method, and we can give any name like error, and here we can pass success is equal to false, and here we can just set the error, so it will be easy to handle for client. And here we can pass error message, or instead data we can set the null, or we can remove it from here. Here I have just added two methods with the data, and the messages are fixed, so we have defined here. If we want to get and change as message also dynamically, so we need to add two more functions. So let me add control C, copy these two methods, and we can do method overloading here, and we can add more function like string message. So we can also pass message from our API response. So I will copy it and will remove the success, and can use the message response. String message. So instead of error, if you want to pass any other message, that we can pass here. So let me go back to controller and we'll change the code here. So here we can just call generic response dot success, and here we will pass the data. So let me copy this line first. So let me remove this generic response dot success and pass this value here. So like this we can also change here. So first I will cut this line from here. After that I will remove this all the code, and here I will call success. So this will also improve our code quality and easy to understand the code. And the code structure, code response structure will also be same, so it will be easy to handle for our client also. So client side, while consuming our APIs, so it can easily handle with the success or failure message. So I have started my application again. So we will check here, our application has started. So now we can see our application has started at port number 8080. So let me go back to browser and call this API again, and we will get the same response. So here first I will call get employee. So this API will return all the list of employee. So this is the same structure that we have declared by using common structure for all API response. Success, true, message is success, and data that we have declared inside our generic response model class. So if you want to change the message that we are returning here, so we have hard coded this success message that we have passed here, success. If you want to do change, so we can call the another function that we have also defined inside our generic response model class. So inside generic model class, we have declared two success methods, one with single parameter and second success with two parameter. So if you want to change the message, we can call this success message, success function, and we can pass message from here. So let me call this API again. And here I will just copy. So we can also declare the constant, and from constants we can get these values. So here I have changed only in single API, that is get employee name. So let me stop and start it again. So I have done these changes only for single API, that is get employee name with the help of ID. Here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. Now I will just call the API get employee name. So go back to our Swagger UI. So here I will go and search for this API. So this is the get employee name by ID. So let me call with the value 14. So here we will get the response, that is get name successfully is the message that we have passed from our controller class. So we are getting the same that we have passed from here. So what are the main benefits of using these generic response model? These are the main five benefits. First is standard response structure. So all API responses follow the same basic structure. So this makes it easier for client-side application to process our API response. And the second main benefit of using this generic response is error handling. So errors returned from the API can be easily managed. So we can just return the error message from anywhere in the API, and it can be notified to the client with an error message defined in the generic response object and a boolean value expressing the failure status. And the third main benefit is flexibility. So we can carry different types of data in the data field that we have declared here inside our generic response. Here we have defined data field, so it can carry any type of data. So this allows us to carry a wide variety of data types with a single response class. And the another main benefit is consistency. So returning a consistent response for both successful and unsuccessful transaction mode through the API makes it easier to develop and maintain client application. And another main benefit is maintainability. So it is important that the API is ready for future changes and expressions. So by using generic response, it becomes easy to add a new field, or we can change the existing field also. Now we can learn how to use generic response with the response entity class. So if we want to use response entity class also along with generic response, then we can also use. And the main benefit of using a response entity with the help of with generic response, it will be easy to change our status code and headers if you want to pass extra header, or we can handle also. Here I have added response entity. So here we need to do some few changes. So here I will just pass response entity dot status http status dot ok. Dot body and close this bracket here, so everything will be inside the body. And if you want to pass custom headers, So we can use headers, custom header, and we can keep any value like 1, 2, 3. So like this we can do the changes, and we can also use response entity along with our generic response. And if you want to change status code, so we can change it from here. We can also use created, it means it will return 201. So let me stop the application and start it again. So I have done the changes for single API, that is get employee by name. So we can do these changes in all the APIs. So it will return same structure for all API response. So once our application will be start, we will just call single API. So our application has started at port number 8080. So let me go to browser and we'll call get employee name with the help of its ID. So let me execute. So now we will get the some different status code 201, because this time I have set it HTTP status is created. So here I am getting status code is 201, and inside response body we are getting this. And here we can see the one extra header that we have passed with the help of response entity. So as we know that response entity is used to provide control at the HTTP level, and we can fine tune the HTTP protocol, like we can change the status code and can add more headers. So generic response is used to create a standard response format at our application level. So this was all about how to use generic response along with the response entity. So these are the main benefits. So thanks for watching this video.